Here with me now, someone who will be returning to Congress come January and who had a hand in helping elect all those Democrats, Congressman Hakeem Jeffries, Democrat of New York. How does it change Congress to have this many new people in your caucus from this many new different backgrounds?
Well, it's a phenomenal thing, and they are the majority makers. And in many ways, we will clearly represent the gorgeous mosaic of the American people. You know, we're black, we're white, we're Latino, we're Asian, we're men, we're women, we're young, we're older, we're gay, we're straight.
Let me just stop you there and say, young and older, spoken like a true politician.
Well, we've got seasoned members, and we've got newer members who've never served in elected office. It's been a great combination. And many of these individuals, Chris, as you know, they're veterans, they're national security professionals, they're super moms, they're nurses, they're activists. It really runs the gamut, and they will supercharge and energize the new Congress next year.
Is it strange? You got the House Republican caucus is now, I think, 90% white men, and the Democratic caucus is going to be 38% white men. I mean, there is something striking about the demographic fissures of American politics being so replicated in your workplace.
Well, we absolutely represent the face of America in every facet possible, which is consistent with what the Congress should look like, particularly the People's House here in the House of Representatives, which, as you know, the Founding Fathers envisioned as the most direct representatives of the American people. And when you look at the other side of the aisle, it's like a country club that is pretty exclusive. And I think that is the direction that we've seen our colleagues in the Republican Party go in, and they're going to need to reverse course or they're going to lose America.
There's a leadership, all sorts of leadership talk. So there's going to be leadership elections. I think you're running for House Caucus Chair, if I'm not mistaken. Some other folks running for that position as well. What do you make of there's a letter out today of a bunch of Democrats saying they don't want to vote. They won't vote for Nancy Pelosi. I think 15 or 20 of those. Is there a serious challenge to her speakership or not?
Well, I think that she's got the votes to be the speaker designee. I'm certainly going to support her effort. And on her path toward 218, I'll be one of the people that support her. She led us into the majority once in 2006 and has now led us back into the majority. But of course, there is a desire, Chris, as you know, for generational change and for that to be reflected in the leadership in some way, shape, or form. Hopefully, we'll be able to work this all out in a manner that will allow us to then focus on the things that we promised the American people we would do, lowering health care costs, increasing pay, cleaning up the mess and corruption here in Washington.
Let me stop you there, because you said that the desire for generational change, which to me is the most compelling. I have a hard time figuring out what the argument about Nancy Pelosi is. Is it a personal one about who she is and her ineffectiveness as a leader? Is it an ideological one, or is it a political one because people are on the trail and she's been turned into this lightning rod, I think, largely by conservative media? Or is it the generational argument? Is that, do you think, the argument that's driving all this?
Well, I do think that there are people of goodwill who have legitimately concluded that our leadership moving forward and in terms of how we run the House has got to allow everyone to be on the playing field so they can contribute and elevate the aspirations and dreams of the districts that they represent. But I do believe that there's a way for us to work this out. And the bottom line is, as you've pointed out, the other side, right-wing conservatives, tried to weaponize Nancy Pelosi to stop us from seizing the majority. It didn't work. We've seized the majority.
Yeah, it's a pretty good political argument. It would also be a little weird if after losing in 2010, 2012, and 2014, re-electing Nancy Pelosi, and then after winning in 2018 to dump her.
Certainly, and that is a case that's being made, and that we shouldn't let the other side dictate to us how we proceed.
Yeah.
I think you'll see a more inclusive Congress in the next Congress in terms of how we provide opportunities to newly arriving members to fully display their talent and ability.
All right, Congressman Hakeem Jeffries of Brooklyn, thank you very much for your time.